Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday Morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today, we're going to do a recipe out of this old cookbook, simply called Tennessee Cookbook. This was published in 1912 in Nashville, Tennessee, and it is a great little cookbook. There are a lot of interesting recipes in here, a lot of recipes that I want to explore, but I haven't had enough time with this book to really go through and cross-reference the recipes with other things. And it's telling of its time. There are recipes in here for mock brains. There's a whole chapter on oyster recipes, things that you would think of as today being relatively expensive, oysters. But in 1912, they were dirt cheap. There's a lot of really good country cooking in this book, very rural cooking, and some amazing sounding recipes. But the one that sort of drew me first that we're going to do today is a recipe that I haven't been able to find any information on. It's called Nut Crumpets. Don't Google Nut Crumpets. And I'm confounded by the recipe because I don't know what to do about it. Let me just put the butter in here and we'll start creaming it. And then we'll talk about the recipe. Okay, so the recipe reads just like this. 1 egg, 1/2 cup each of sugar and butter, 1 cup of milk, 1 of chopped nut meats, 2.5 of flour, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Drop by spoonfuls into a greased pan and bake. There's no real method here for how these are made. So one would assume that in 1912, if you had this book, you knew what a nut crumpet was and you didn't need a lot of direction on how to make them. I look at the recipe and I think to myself, there's 2 ways that this could go. I could make it like a cookie or a cake. It is in the small cake section, which is, generally speaking, cookies and cakes, although there's donuts in here as well, which is what I'm doing, creaming the butter and then creaming in the sugar and then the egg, just like you would make any cookie or cake. The other way to look at this would be, is it like a biscuit? Because to me, crumpets, well, it's not a crumpet. It has nothing to do with crumpets. It's unlike any crumpet recipe that I've ever seen, which is usually more of a batter that has yeast that you drop into a pan, into a ring, and you not quite fry it, but you essentially fry it. This you drop by spoonful. I could make it like a biscuit, which is a different order of method, where I would first cut the butter into the flour to coat the flour with the butter and then add all of the other ingredients to come up with more of a dough that you could then roll out and cut. But it says to drop. Now there is a class of tea biscuits that are made quite frequently here in Canada where you do drop it by spoonful onto a pan. For some reason, I chose to make them like cookies. And I know that the outcome of the difference in methods is completely different. So we're gonna go this way. We're gonna see what happens. And if it doesn't work out, then in a future video, we'll come back to it and we'll do it the other way. So, creaming together the butter and sugar. While that's creaming together, I have some flour here and I'm going to add salt and baking powder. And we'll just give that a quick mix together. You don't have to go all out. That's good. Now, I'm going to crack the egg into the mixer. Next in are nut meats. It doesn't specify what kind. I'm using pecans because I really like pecans, but I imagine you could put any kind of nut meat you like into your nut crumpets. That mixes in really quickly. So next is the flour, and a little bit at a time, just until it's mixed. And I'm gonna alternate the flour with the cup of milk that I'm supposed to put in. A little bit of milk, a little bit of flour, a little bit of milk, a little bit of flour. So pour out a cup of milk. And we'll dribble that in. and a little bit of flour. Now, it says to drop them by the spoonful onto a greased sheet pan. I've got a piece of parchment paper on mine. I don't really like greasing them. I think the parchment is going to work just fine. So, drop by spoonfuls. It's an interesting consistency. And I don't know. There we go. Spoonful. Let's see what happens. I'm a little bit confused. I must say, I'm a little bit confused. And I'm interested in what the outcome is. Like most recipes from this time period, there is no temperature for the oven. I've chosen 350 because 350 is kind of what you would bake almost anything at this point. So I'll get these in the oven and we'll see what happens. I have no idea how much these are going to spread either. Maybe I'm putting them too close together. Maybe I'm making them too big. Experimenting in the kitchen.
Hi, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. What are you reading?
Well, I'm just looking at, you know, jelly chicken a la tomato aspic.
Oh, I know how much you love the aspic.
Aspic. I love tomato aspic. Okay, so that's not what we made today.
No, clearly not.
We made Tennessee nut crumpets.
Nut crumpets?
Nut crumpets.
Are there actual nuts in them?
There are. They're pecans. Okay. They're very...
So I can see why they're why they say the crumpets, because they're very... They got lots of little holes in
them. Lots of little holes, but no holes on the top, no yeast, but that sort of...
Mm-hmm.
And it's in the little cake section, so it's not quite a cookie.
It's more biscuit-like,
mm-hmm.
Right? Because it's not super sweet.
It does have a biscuit flavor because it's lacking flavor. It's got a texture like a muffin top.
Yeah, like I would want to, I would put jam with it.
Mm-hmm.
Or, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
It is a perfect vessel for jam.
Yeah. I mean, that's pretty good. If you put it with something.
Yeah, it's a biscuit. It's a sweet biscuit.
It is a slightly sweet biscuit with nuts in it. You could definitely flavor it, though, with something. I mean, you could put in some vanilla. You could put in some lemon.
You could even just put in some additional dried things, like dried fruits.
Yeah.
Other nuts. Chocolate chips. Chocolate chips.
Yeah. And I feel like this is something that is only good on day one. Because of the texture, it would dry out really quickly.
So we have to eat all of these.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they'd be really good in the actually, they'd be really good in like the spring and summer when you've got fresh fruit
mm-hmm.
to put with it.
Mm-hmm.
Like you put a compote on it.
Mm-hmm.
And it always make, you know what? Always making up more ideas, eh?
Well, and then you could take, I mean, it does have a very much like a drop biscuit that my grandmother would make.
Yeah. Yeah, you would never... Say, have a cookie and give this to someone, and they would probably not be very happy with it.
No. But, say, have a Tennessee nut crumpet, and people...
They're all in.
They're all in.
So, oh, you got some jam with that?
Got some jam with that. So, I think this is a pretty good thing. Something I've never had before. I had no expectations of what this was going to be.
I do really like the texture.
Yeah. I do, too.
But mm-hmm. you just have to dream about what it can be instead of what it is right now.
Okay. So, let me know... If you're from Tennessee and you've ever had nut crumpets, I can't seem to find this recipe anywhere else. So, in the comments section, let us know. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.